una vez un gran rey que tenía muchas tierras, un castillo y también un amor. Pero los caprichos de ese amor, con el tiempo sin castillo y sin tierras lo dejó.
All right. Welcome back in. You found us once again. Shoot the Gap, the Rabbit Hole Fantasy Football Focus Show, here to help you make good educational decisions for your fantasy football team. I am your humble MC, Brian the Amigo Baldwin, and I am honored to be here to help you on your trek, okay, to hopefully to a championship. Yeah, so my hope is that if you're watching this, that means that you're either playing a DFS or you are in the championship game, which I am. One of my teams, the other one, to be honest with you, Tyreek Hill got me. Tyreek Hill is a combination of Tyreek Hill and Alvin Kamara. Yeah, I mean, you figure if you have those two guys on your team that you won. Nope. No. Yeah. Last week he got me. So I'm out. And so that was the one I was defending my title. So that one's going to be a new champion. However, in my new league, I am in that championship game. So, Lord, I hope that you bless me and allow me to get another championship ring. All right. So this is now our 105th show. Now it's January 1st. So it's our first show of 2022, all right, and this hopeful year. Yeah, we'll call this a hopeful year. And you know, and this show, I'm telling you, it's go time. Okay, all right. So, well, I'm just gonna, like, normally I'm gonna do a little bit of a breach of an etiquette. So normally I go through news, you know, the good news, and, you know, of course, Merry Early Christmas or Merry Christmas or what have you, where I tell you about any type of injuries and things like that. But you know what? I got 16 games to go, okay? And I'm really hoping that this thing will be either at an hour or actually under an hour. That's what I'm hoping for. So with that in mind, okay, I just want to go ahead and go straight into the Shooter Sees Fire. And as we go over the games, and of course, there'll be news that will pop up and that I'll talk about there. So, you know, we'll just we're just being a little bit more efficient in the, you know, in this one, because I don't know about you guys, I'm stressed out. I'm stressed out from the championship thing. So, you know, I'm hopefully this information will help. But before we get started, you know, of course, we want to go ahead and thank the supporters of the show. Sports Host app, of course, the Nothing But Love, you know, sports social app. You know, if you're tired of the Twitter, make sure and go check out Sports Host app. You'll be glad that you did. It's a that you can download, and you can go and converse with other sports fans, and it's about different types of sports, so it's not just relegated to, like, you know, to football and baseball and basketball. I mean, all that's there, but you can talk about cricket, disc golf, you know, all types of different type of sports if you like, and, you know, and it's Nothing But Love there, so it's a great, great sports app, so make sure and check that out. The link is below, and also, High Volume Music Radio. Yeah, man, High Volume Music Radio. Make sure and check out that app. I mean, you can get all types of, first of all, you get all types of incredible music, right? And just eclectic music, and 24/7. So anytime you want to hear some music, just pop it on. But they also have different shows, you know, such as Andrew Beats Vocal Sounds, Rock and Roll Radio, Bring Back the 8-Track, Access Granted, Brown Sugar Express, What's on Your Mind, with Am Boogie, Blame It on the Boogie, the Monday Mixtape, and of course, Drive Time Sports with Charlie and me, Brian. Yeah, so make sure to download that app or check them out at highvolumemusic.com. If it ain't high volume, it ain't loud enough. So, okay, so with all that said, that quick, hello, how you do? Happy New Year type of thing. Let's go ahead and let's jump straight into the Shoot or Cease Fire. So let's go ahead and start with New York Giants, 4-11 at Chicago Bears, who are 5-10. Now, this is one thing that right off the bat, I've been watching, you know, again, I'm in a championship game, so I'm checking out as much as I can, probably to my detriment. Okay, I'm probably gonna have paralysis by analysis type of thing. But one thing that was constant through all, because that's what I'm looking for, constants, right? You know, what's the same through all the, you know, thinkings. And one thing that was constant, nobody was talking about the weather. Everybody's talking like it's, you know, it's freaking California, 85 degrees, sunny outside, you know, type of thing. Yeah, but no, there's some serious weather that's happening on these games that we need to talk about, okay, that need to be discussed. And I'm going to tell you stuff that, like, I'm not going to say, well, you know, it's a little bit like this, or if you want to look at it from this angle, that's okay. I'm going to tell you how I feel, you know, so hopefully I'm here to try to help you make your best decision. So I'm going to tell you what my analysis says, you know, by what I've researched and what I've seen. So with that in mind, Chicago, New York Giants at Chicago, it's a noon game. Listen to this, 25 degrees out, okay, 50% chance of snow, 20 to 30 mile an hour and higher gusts possible. Okay, I mean, this is what I'm talking about. Nobody's talking about this, all right? And Vegas does agree with me on this one. There's a couple of them that Vegas doesn't agree with me on, which makes me a little nervous, but it does agree with this one. 37 opening over and under. The implied Vegas point total is the Bears, 21.5, and Giants, 15.5. So I'm taking the way under on that. I'm telling you, it's not going to be good. It's not going to be good. Who would I shoot on? New York Giants. One guy. Mm-hmm. There is actually somebody that I found in there that I would shoot on. Saquon Barkley. Let me explain. Okay. I know the O-line is awful and the QB situation is a joke, but you never count out Matt Nagy. Okay. If anyone can screw this situation up, it's him. And I think Barkley is going to surprise people due to Nagy not preparing his team properly. Okay. It seems true to me that he thinks he's secure after that, after Seattle crumbling last week. And so he's not going to be so have a lockdown defense thing, right? He's going to think the weather's okay. He's fine. But he thinks that Chicago won that game. Okay, and the truth is that Seattle actually lost it. It's just that simple, all right? So, yeah, so Saquon Barkley, it's a snow game. That's why I chose the running back, you know, because the snow games equal good games for running backs, okay? If they're featured running backs, and, you know, Saquon still is in the good category, you know? So, yeah, so that's why. And another thing I wanted to talk about, well, let's just go into shoots on for Chicago. It kind of works its way in there. David Montgomery. Okay, I told you the run. You know, you want to make sure and do the run. But the defense. Okay, let's talk about the defense, right? Because that's the hot streamer for championship week. Make sure and get Chicago. Make sure and get Chicago. Make sure and get Chicago. All right. So the weather does scream a great fantasy output for the defense. Because normally, I mean, whenever you see snow, it's like, yay for defense, yay for running back. You know, bad for everybody else, right? You know, so I don't need to tell you. We'll get to ceasefire, but spoiler alert, I'm ceasefire on the kickers, okay? Back to the defense for Chicago, all right? So the weather, great fantasy output for the defense, it looks like, right? But there's lack of talent. Okay, there's lack of talent. They've had a lot of injuries. All right, and Matt Nagy. Okay, so I think that all that tells a different story. So you just can't go and just with a rubber stamp and go, okay, snow game, defense will be great. No, I don't think you can do that. Ceasefire. New York Giants, of course, everybody else. I, you know, kind of already dipped into there. And Chicago, yeah. Darnell Mooney, nobody else. Okay. Yeah. No Cole Kmet. You know, I know that he's very popular. You can start him, I guess, because of how the landscape of the tight ends are, but it's not somebody that I'm excited to start. It's like one of those things where I'm just hoping for, well, a touchdown, you know, but come on, man, you know, it's snow, Nagy, you see what I'm talking about. So, and actually, this is one that really has a chance, that really has a really good chance, in my opinion, of being an upset. So just keep all that in mind when you're making your decisions. And maybe if you're on the fence on something, maybe I might have helped you out. Okay, well, let's go ahead and move on to Jacksonville 2-3 at New England 9-6. Now, this is a noon game, 48 degrees because it's in New England, 40% chance of rain, 5 to 10 mile an hour wind. 41.5 point over under, and the implied Vegas total point totals are Patriots 28.5, Jaguars 13. All right, so the Jaguars is real easy, and it's obvious. Don't shoot on anybody. Okay, ceasefire on everybody on Jacksonville. I know. You know, people are all excited about Daria Agumbawale, right? But when all the experts are saying that you should start him because, listen to this, New England hasn't been that bad versus the run, and he'll get 15-plus touches. Listen, this is the championship week, okay? All right, so, you know, he'll get 15-plus touches, but it's going to be against New England, right? You know, so, and again, the argument is, New England's hasn't been that bad versus the run. I mean, dude, come on, what kind of argument is that, right? So I'm not down with that. You know, I would not go with them. I'd go with somebody else if all possible. All right. And also, it seems true to me that Jacksonville's going to get behind, and they're going to try to like abandon the run. It's going to be more passing. So it just doesn't seem like a good thing for the running backs. Now, I know that Agumbawale, I know that he's a pass-catching back, but he'll be sharing those duties also. So it's just against New England, you know. So, yeah, I wouldn't do it, not in championship week. Who would I shoot on New England? Ramondre Stevenson. Yeah. Now he's back from COVID earlier in the week, and it seems true to me that New England will give Stevenson the bulk of the snaps to give Damian Harris's hamstring a rest for the playoffs, since they won't need him. Okay, so Hunter Henry, now he's tied. Hunter Henry is somebody also that I would go ahead and shoot on. Okay, he's tied with Mark Andrews and Dawson Knox with 9 touchdowns on the season. And that's the most among tight end everybody. All right. The defense, of course, I would go and shoot on New England's defense. And also Nick Folk. Okay. I would go ahead and shoot on Nick Folk, but this is where I'm different, because I know, hot take, right? Start Nick Folk, the point leader for kickers. You know, yeah, start him in the championship game right now. I'm saying to temper expectations, because the Jacksonville defense hasn't been that bad. No, I'm kidding. The Jacksonville defense really, you know, is they are so bad that New England won't really need to kick that much. Okay, you know, and now the weather's a little worrisome too. Okay, so I don't know, man. It just seems to me, it seems true to me that they'd do more like go for it and fourth and kick it in this game, mainly because they'd want to keep the ball and just keep the clock going. New England, who would I cease fire on? Mac Jones and all the pass catchers except for Hunter Henry, because that weather, I know. And again, you know, if you want to hear it again, 40% chance of rain, 5 to 10 mile an hour wind, makes me nervous. Okay. Makes me nervous, but, if I had to, in a bind, Mac Jones will, in my opinion, will be like a low QB1, right? But he has a does go ahead and turn it over. Jacksonville's defense has been a little opportunistic, right? So you can look at turnovers happening for Mac Jones that will lessen him. And all of his receivers, you know, with Jacoby Myers, I think he's still a little banged up. So maybe if you want to go after that guy, I don't know. It just seems like they're going to be running it a lot, considering, like I said, the weather, and also just it's that's a strength of New England. So that's just what they do. Okay, so moving on, let's go to Tampa Bay at New York Jets. Yeah, so I have Tampa Bay, yeah, 11-4 versus New York Jets, 4-11. I had those things backwards. That's why you might have heard me stop for a second, because I was like, Tampa Bay 4-11, that's not right, you know. But no, I see what I did there. Listen, I worked on this today, and of course last night was New Year's Eve, but man, I wanted to get this out so to help you guys out during the championship. There's little things like that, but the data is sound. I guarantee that. Okay, it's a noon game. It's in New York, so it's 54 degrees, 40% chance of rain, 10 to 15 mile an hour wind, 14.5 point open over and under, I would take, and the implied point total is the Bucks at 29.25 and the Jets at 16. So with that in mind, I would say, it's a good line. Let's go under. Because I don't think the Jets will be able to get up that high. And I think that if the Buccaneers get to like 30, you know, that they would start running it more. So, you know, I just doesn't look like the Jets are going to be able to pull their weight on that one. Excuse me. Okay, who do I shoot on? Tampa Bay. Brady, of course. Gronk. You know, you're not sitting on any of these guys during championship week, okay? Ronald Jones Jr. How about this? This one's exciting. This guy could win you your league this week, you know, so because he's a great running back. He's going to have all the work. He's against the Jets. You know, 1-1 equals 2 sometimes. Antonio Brown. If he plays, you know, I would go ahead and shoot on him, you know, but he tweaked his ankle during practice, so watch out for that. And the defense, I would go ahead and shoot on, and Ryan suck up the kicker for Tampa Bay. The Jets, real easy. Nobody, you know, I mean, you've heard me before that I was really excited about Michael Carter. He was going to be my running back, too. But he wasn't going to be my running back too this time, you know, for this week. That was never the plan, you know, against Tampa Bay. I know that Tevin Coleman, see a little bit of news here. He got put on COVID, on the COVID list. So that leaves more touches for Carter. I just don't think that he's going to be able to produce, you know, it's just a Tampa Bay defense, man. They're gearing up. This is when they're pumping. They're starting to get ready for the playoffs, you know, so there's no like laying back, you know, the humdrum of the middle of the season. You know, they're pumping up. They're getting ready. They've done this before. They're defending champions. They know what they need to do. So, yeah, it's going to be awful for the Jets. And then also, let's see here on Tampa Bay. So Tampa Bay. So who would I see fire on? Any other wide receiver other than Brown? You know, even if Brown misses, you know, Brady should spread it out enough to where not one of those wide receivers is going to be fantasy relevant. So you know, it's that plus the game really does scream run heavy. It really does, you know. So I just think that in championship week, go Ronald Jones Jr. And again, like Brady and Gronk, you're just not going to sit them. It doesn't matter what I say, you know, that you're not going to sit. You're just going to go ahead and start them. So why fight it? Just be you. It's your lineup. Enjoy it. You know, this is our last lineup we get to set. So, you know, do what you want, man. You know, do what you like. That's what Humpty says. All right, moving on to Atlanta. Okay, Atlanta 7-8 at Buffalo 9-6. Now, this is one what infuriates me. Okay, and what I say about that is that nobody's talking about the weather. Let me talk to you about the weather, guys. Okay, let me talk about the weather here. It's a noon game. It's gonna be 31 degrees. 90% chance of snow, 10 to 20 mile an hour winds, 1 to 3 inches of snow expected. Okay. Okay. I mean, so no, none of the fantasy experts are talking about this. They're talking about like it's California. Oh, it's gonna be sunny, 85. No. We're talking about the snow. Now, I will tell you that before I started filming, when I wrote this, that's what the forecast was saying. Before I started filming, I went back and took a look, and the winds are calming down to about 10 miles an hour, okay? Still going to be snowy. Still going to be cold. Still going to be snowy. Still a bad situation, all right? You know, it's not conducive for passing. It's not conducive for kicking. It's conducive for running, and it's conducive for defense. Let's go over it, all right? So, Here's also the opening. See, this is the one that freaks me out. So the opening, maybe it's changed. Hopefully it's changed. Lord willing, it's changed. But as the time when I wrote it, it was 44 points open over and under, and the implied totals was Bills 29, Falcons 14. Okay, so I don't think that that's going to happen for the Falcons. I don't think they're going to get up that high. All right, I think that the Bills are probably going to be at around 29. You know, right? You know, like around 28. That sounds about right. Maybe 31. You know, if they kick a field goal. You know, but even again, you know, kicking a field goal. You know, in this weather, dude, it's snow. It's cold. You know, snow is precipitation. It makes those balls heavy. Cold makes those balls heavy. You know what heavy balls don't do? They don't fly, man. Okay, so that's going to cut down on a lot of stuff. So let's go over it. Let's shoot. Who would I shoot on Atlanta? Nobody. Okay, nobody. Come on, man. You know, they're a dome team. All right, and they're playing against New England? No. Not going to do it. Buffalo. Who would I shoot on? I would only shoot on Josh Allen and Stephon Diggs because, you know, they're the ones who got you there. But if you have a better option, pivot. All right, I'm telling you, okay? I know it sounds crazy, all right? But pivot. I'd start Derek Carr over Josh Allen. I'd start Amon-Ra St. Brown over Diggs. All right. The last time Buffalo played in weather this bad, it was versus New England. Okay, the winds was a little higher, right? But still, it's bad weather. All right, and they threw the ball less than 10 times. Okay, so that wind's fluctuating on you. Okay, so it's what we do know, it's gonna be snowy. What we do know, it's gonna be cold. What we do know is that the Atlanta defense is not very good against the run. So Devin Singletary, all right, Devin Singletary is potentially a championship game winner for you. Okay, he really is. All right, Atlanta is the ninth best matchup versus running backs, meaning that if you're a running back and you're looking at a list of who you want to play, okay, out of all 32 teams, Atlanta's number nine, okay, because of their matchup and the points that they give. They give over double-digit points to the running back every game, all right? So now this is a bad weather game, okay? In the last bad weather game, Buffalo ran the ball over 20 times, okay? They rushed for over 20 times. Now, some of it was Josh Allen, but Josh Allen's picked up that toe injury, and they want to make sure that he's going to be healthy for the playoffs, okay? And now Singletary is the lead dog in Buffalo, okay? So he looks like he's going to smash on. He's going to do incredible. He's going to do incredible on Sunday. I mean, I have him. I put him in my lineup, and in fact, I'll tell you right now what I did is I took out Justin Jefferson. Yeah, I mean that's a little preview down the road, but yeah, I'm sitting Justin Jefferson, putting Amon-Ra St. Brown, who was in the flex, putting him into that spot, and then in the flex I'm putting Devin Singletary because of what I see here, and that's for my championship game. So we'll see what the Lord says. Of course, it doesn't matter like how smart I am or anything like that. If it's not the Lord's will, it's just not going to happen. That's something that we all need to accept in fantasy football. We can try as hard as we can. Call it what you want. I call it the Lord's will. If it's the Lord's will, it's just not going to happen. But if it's the Lord's will, it is going to happen. Just like me with Cowboys defense. I'm only in the championship game because they blocked that punt and got the touchdown. It's just incredible. I mean, just thank you, Jesus. Okay, thank you, Lord. Yeah, for your glory. All for your glory. Okay, let's keep going. Dawson Knox, all right? I would go ahead and I would shoot on him. I told you about the passing and everything like that. But again, it doesn't go far. Dawson Knox is a short guy. Short spot receiver. He does go down the field sometimes, but he produces very well close to the line of scrimmage. So, and also the tight end landscape is not good, and he could catch a touchdown in this game. Buffalo, they need to win this game since they are tied with New England for first in the North. So yeah, they absolutely need to do that. And I would go and shoot on the defense. Already sees fire on Atlanta. I told you about that, dude. How about this? This is kills me, man. Cause I drafted this guy, and I was depending on him. You know, when I saw this, like when I was getting ready for championship week, you know, or for the playoffs, I saw this on championship week for this guy. I was super excited about it. I was like, cool. One less thing I have to worry about. Tyler Bass. No. The weather, man. He only had 7 points in that last bad weather game. And Atlanta D. Okay, come on. Well, Atlanta defense, do you think they're really going to force that many fourth downs? Do you really think that? No. Mm-mm. Yeah. Now, not with Devin Singletary running the rock, dude. It's just no. Gabe Davis, Cole Beasley, Isaiah McKenzie, Emmanuel Sanders. Again, the last time Buffalo played in weather this bad, just a few weeks ago, they threw the ball less than 10 times. So, you know, everybody knows it's Allen first and then those guys next. So, yeah, and it's going to be split up between them. So I just wouldn't do it. So, yeah, God bless you if you have anybody in that game. I didn't tell you, finish telling you, Tyler Bass, I am going to go ahead and I'm pivoting away from him. Okay, so I think I'm going to go Jake Elliott. Yeah, we'll get to that here pretty soon. Okay, all right, well, let's go ahead and move on. It's to Kansas City, 11-4, at Cincinnati, 9-6. It's a noon game, 40 degrees, 50% chance of rain/snow mix, 16-mile-an-hour winds, something to keep in mind, 51-point over-under. And the applied Vegas is Chiefs 28, Bengals 23. I would go under. I don't think the Bengals are going to do that well. Again, this is another game. Okay, it's another game. Okay, where weather's playing a huge part. All right, but no one is mentioning it. Yeah, 50% chance of rain and snow. 16-mile-an-hour wind. Dude, that's rough. All right, so let's go over it here. Shoot. I would shoot on Kansas City. Okay. On Kansas City, I would shoot on Mahomes, Tyreek Hill, and Kelsey. But temper your expectations. I would prepare for more of a floor game with all threes due to Cincinnati's D is better than ever advertised, and of course the weather. All right, so not saying don't start them. I'm just saying don't expect any much. And just to give you a little extra, the floor for Hill. Look what he did last week. Okay, or I know it's COVID. All right, look what he did a couple weeks ago. Okay, you know, so he's not being consistent right now. And he's going to be in a weather game. Okay. And last I heard, he'll still be hit by the COVID thing, being exhausted. So it's rough. And I don't think they're going to need to run. It's going to be a run thing, I think. Okay. So let's talk about Darrell Williams. Okay. This, again, another potential championship winner. You know, CEH, Clyde Edwards-Helaire, Katie Bone himself is out. Okay. He was declared out today. So, yeah, he won't be there for your championship. Make sure and keep that in mind whenever you're drafting next year. Defense. I would shoot on the defense, like I was telling you, you know, okay. So, Cincinnati, who do I shoot on? Joe Burrow, Jamar Chase, T. Higgins. Same thing as before, you know. Prepare for a floor game. You know, you can start them if you want that floor game, okay, if you don't have any better options, all right? I mean, because let's be honest here, everybody. It's very rare to hit all nine positions on your starting lineup, okay? It really is, okay? There's going to be one donkey there, one that's not going to do as well as you hope. And there's going to be another one that should do better than what you expect, right? So if your donkey, hopefully your donkey isn't, well, Joe Burrow. Yeah, it worked out well. Yeah, or Chase or Higgins. But if it is, make sure you're pumped up in another spot, because just temper your expectations, or prepare your heart, I should say. Defense, I would go ahead and shoot on the defense for Cincinnati. I know it's against Kansas City, but I think they can handle it. Ceasefire. Again, another one that hurt my heart. I have him in another league where I'm going for third place. Harrison Butker, you know, that weather. And I would expect a floor game, you know, and I don't know exactly how COVID affects kickers, and I don't think championship week or third place, whatever game you're playing this week, I just hope that I just don't want that. It's a very important game. It's the last game of the season. I don't want to play that game. And also the all other pass catching options on Kansas City, just don't do it. I know that last week was exciting, but they practiced the whole week without Tyreek Hill, so they had plays and everything. So I don't see that happening again. And even then, there wasn't one real stud there, so who are you going to choose, right? A little shit stick. Cincinnati. Dude, everything else. Seriously, really. I mean, are you going to consider starting CJ Uzoma or Samaje Perine in the championship game? I mean, really? You know, so, I mean, do we really need to talk about it? I don't think that you're really going to consider it. I wouldn't consider it. So, if not, then why waste time talking about it? Yeah, so here we go. Moving on. Miami, 8-7 at Tennessee, 10-5. Now, it's a noon game. 45 degrees, 60% chance of rain and snow, 16-mile-an-hour wind, 40-point over-under, opening over-under for the game. The implied point total is Titans 21, Dolphins 18. Under. It's a bad weather game. Nobody talking about. Okay. You see what I'm talking about? I mean, dude, like right now, as I'm taping, this is Saturday, there's like a tornado warning happening in Tennessee, okay? And nobody's talking about this mess, dude. This stuff matters. Weather matters in fantasy. I can't tell you how many times it was like, man, I had a great matchup, but man, I should have checked that weather report. You know, I mean, that's why, please, like and subscribe to this, man. This is the kind of shooter sees fire that I like to give you, man. Or, you know, start sit stuff as I include the weather here. If nothing else, you at least get a weather report. All right, so shooter, who would I shoot on? Miami? No, nobody. At least no offensive weapons. I mean, the weather's not going to give Tua, Waddle, or Gesicki, you know, enough fantasy points to be relevant, so why even do that? Duke Johnson, you know, he was the lead running back, but now, you know, Myles Gaskin and Philip Lindsay are still being mixed in, so looks like a little bit of a running back by committee there. And an RBBC and a bad weather game against an above-average defense, it's not a good combination. So defense, you know, you could You can shoot on the defense. Yeah, because again, you know, the weather's awful, you know, and that's helpful for the defense. Tennessee. Who would I shoot on? AJ Brown, only because of his volume, you know. And it's difficult to not shoot on that guy, because he's so he's such a big dude that, you know, weather is not really a thing. You know, so, you know, and he catches short passes, so, you know, he's somebody that's going to have good volume. So, you know, I would think wide receiver two numbers, you know, you'll be confident with those. Deontay Foreman, since this should be a run-focused game. All right, so, and he obviously shown that he can do it, so God bless you. Glad you're back, Foreman. That's great. So it's would have been good feels for the Texans, but of course, you know, the Broncos don't need you. Sorry, I don't mean to be that way, but we don't. Moving on, Tennessee defense. Yes, I would go and shoot on Tennessee's defense. Who would I see fire on? Miami, Sanders. Okay, but that's kind of obvious, you know, and the, you know, that because that's the only other person I didn't mention. But again, it's obvious with the weather. Randy Bullock, you know, and all other passing options, you know. So those are the ones that I would go ahead and cease fire on that game. All right. So let's go ahead and move on to Las Vegas, 8-7 at Indianapolis, 9-6. Thank the Lord. Finally came across a dome game, finally. Okay, it's a noon game. It's going to be in a dome. 44.5-point opening over and under. The implied point totals, Colts 25, Raiders 19. I would go over slightly, only because I'm hesitant because I don't think that the Raiders are going to be able to score that amount of points against the Indianapolis defense. But let's go ahead and talk about who we shoot and ceasefire on this thing here real quick. So we have Las Vegas. Derek Carr, you already know how I feel. You know, I mean, I like him better. Well, you know exactly who I was talking about. Than Josh Allen, yeah. Now his numbers aren't good without Darren Waller. Okay, you know, Darren Waller is out for the season now. Okay, finally they finally said it. He's been out for what, 2 months or something like that. You know, and so now they finally said, you know, he's out. So that's very good of you guys to do that. You know, but the thing is that they're gonna have to throw, and just temper your expectations, all right? I just, I was using Derek Carr as a point because that weather, I don't think that Josh Allen's going to do. Put it this way, Derek Carr and Josh Allen think are going to do about the same, but Derek Carr has a little bit more upside because he's going to be in the in a dome, okay? Now, however, he does take a lot of chances, and Indianapolis defense is very opportunistic. So, yeah, you have to keep that in mind. Josh Jacobs, he's startable, but he's more of an RB3 or flex against this Indianapolis defense. Hunter Renfro, the guy's just very dependable when, you know, since Waller left, so you go ahead and keep him in your lineup. And Daniel Carlson, I know that Indianapolis is like, they give up the fewest points to kickers, but he's in a dome, okay? And look at all these other people that, you know, they're in these. So compared to that bad weather, I would take Daniel Carlson in a dome. So, but again, you know, he's not going to be a league winner. He's not going to lose it for you, but he's not going to win it for you. Indianapolis, I would go ahead and just shoot on Jonathan Taylor. Las Vegas is the seventh worst versus the run. I'm talking about as far as like the offensive weapons. Carson Wentz is coming back, confirmed coming back, but the guy did have COVID, was unvaccinated, okay, and I'm not expecting a lot from him, all right? So with that in mind, you know, Jonathan Taylor, he's going to be the guy that it's going to be a run focused game. It's going to be run Jonathan Taylor type time. If you have Jonathan Taylor in your championship, you know, God bless you. You know, you're in a good spot. Defense, I go ahead and shoot on the defense for Indianapolis, and also Michael Badgley. Okay. But, here's the thing. Okay. I will give you the positive and I'll give you the minus on Badgley. Okay. He's in a dome. You already know that. That's a positive. And you have Carson Wentz who's on COVID, so they're probably not going to go for it for fourth. If they're running it a lot, then that means that there's a chance that they're going to be locking it down a little bit, and so they're going to be in spots where they're going to need to kick. Okay, now Michael Badgley last game his missed kick. He's missed one kick out of and in each game, the last three games. That's a bad thing. Okay, that's starting to show like a pattern, right? But this one, in the last game, the reason he was right on, he was right like between the pipes, man. He was right there, like accurate. However, it was a 53-yard kick and he fell short. My point is that this guy doesn't look like he can hit the 50 yarders. All right, so you know, this guy won't lose you your game, but I'm not sure he's gonna win it, because those long kicks, you know, the Young Wei Koo kicks, you know, Nick Folk, you know, these guys, Tucker, you know, these are the guys that kick long kicks and they win you your games. Bucker, you know, they kick those long ones, you know, and that's where the secret of the kicker, you know, helping you out is, right? But if you can't hit the 50 yarder, it's more of a safety valve type thing, you know. So but it is a steady floor production, okay, but just not much upside. However, I was talking to my wife about this earlier. Is like, you know, okay, great, he can't hit the 50s, but look, let's think that they're getting down the red zone, they're trying to run, they can't pass it because of Carson's health, they're gonna kick it. So let's say if they do, and you know, they're playing against Vegas, so you know that is an exploitable defense. It's got, you know, about 12 points last week, you know, so why don't they just, you know, he could be kicking like a lot of 30 somethings, and you know, and those rack up, you know, pretty quickly, you know, times three, you know, times something by three, it'll start adding up pretty quick, you know. The Trinity there, ceasefire on here. Okay, but you understand what I'm saying. Bagley, considering all that weather mess going on, I would go ahead and take him. Definitely. See, who had a ceasefire on? Las Vegas. All other pass catching options, even if Nelson Aguilar is back, because he is on the COVID list. So if he's back, I wouldn't start him. If he's off, I still doesn't open up stuff for other people. Just stay away from that because of the Indianapolis defense, right? You know, but and I know what I'm telling you, it sounds like I'm not really telling the right story, because I'm telling you that I like Derek Carr. Well, Hunter Renfro, I'm telling you, like all other pass catching offerings, I think it's going to be Hunter Renfro, you know, Jacobs catching the most, you know. And then Indianapolis. Oh, Foster Moreau, let's talk about him real quick. Indianapolis, they're really, they give up a lot of points to the tight end spot, but Foster Moreau really isn't that good, in my opinion. So, or at least he's not consistent enough to be considered good. So I would not want to bet on him on my championship week. Indianapolis. Carson Wentz and all the pass catching options. Even though Wentz is back, again, the dude had COVID. So just don't expect much production from anybody. So that's all the other pass catch options, dude. I would go ahead and downgrade those. And then just try to move on to something different. Okay. So let's go and move on to Philadelphia, 8-7 at Washington Team Football, who's 6-9. Noon. 66 degrees, 15% chance of rain, 10 to 20 mile an hour winds. The opening over and under 44.5 points. The implied totals are Eagles 24, Washington 20. Under. I'm going to go under. I don't think Washington's going to be able to get close to that. And I'm not sure if the Eagles are going to be able to get. I think the Eagles are going to probably get like around 28. Okay, so they'll maybe get about 30, maybe about 6 more points. But that's about it. You know, it's not going to be enough to hit that 44.5, I don't think. But who would I shoot on? Philadelphia. Jalen Hurts. He finished as a top 12 QB 11 times this season. Jordan Howard. If he plays now, he's the lead back, and he caught his first two receptions of the season last week. Dallas Goedert. You're always starting that dude because of tight end landscape. Jake Elliott. Yeah. Now, here's what's exciting about that. All right. Is that when I wrote this, the winds were pretty high and were going to be forecasted pretty high in Washington, right? You know, that's where they're playing. But it's since now calmed down to about 7 degrees, or seven miles an hour, excuse me. You know, it's forecast to be 7 to 9 miles an hour, which that's a lot better. And also something like 15% chance of rain or something. Like, well, yeah, there is 15% chance of rain. So, you know, that's really good, you know. That should be good for the kicker. The only problem is that I'm not sure if the WTF defense will force a lot of fourth downs. But if they do, Jake Elliott is a good kicker. He's able to hit the 50 yarders. He missed a game. Missed a a kick last week. It was his first kick, but then after that, he was money from that point on. So he's dependable. That's the guy that I'm telling you I think I'm going to go and flex to is him. You know, I'm really trying to decide between Badgley and between Elliott. But with that, with the wins going down, I think I'm going to go with Elliott. Because, man, missing three kicks in a row, like our game, like at one kick each game for three games, and also not be able to hit over 50, that makes me so nervous about Badgley. And also, I don't like the fact that he calls himself the Money Badger. It's just, you know, I mean, I don't know about you guys in y'all's life, but if, whenever I get too, like, you know, cock strong, you know, cock of the walk type stuff, the Lord always comes down and humbles me, man. So in the end, so that's what might happen with this guy. So, you know, championship week, I don't know if I want to play with that karma, you know? So, okay, let's go ahead and talk about, okay. And of course the defense, I would go ahead and shoot on the defense. WTF, real easy. No one. Don't shoot anybody. So we'll do the ceasefire and the shoot at the same time here on WTF. Nobody. Even Terry McLaurin is too inconsistent to start on this team. Now, there was a rush to pick up Jarrett Patterson after the news of Antonio Gibson being out, but Philly has allowed just 104.6 yards per game to running backs, and he'll be splitting that time with Jonathan Williams. So, come on, man. That's not going to be like, you know, it will. How about this? You know, he probably won't lose you your game, but he's definitely not going to win it for you. All right, that's Patterson, that is. The tight ends. Now, you know, even those guys, they're in a committee. And even though it's in a good matchup, you know, against Philadelphia, it's a committee. So you just don't know who it's going to be. You know, if it's going to be Bates or if it's going to be Ricky Seals-Jones, which is unfortunate. I was really happy for Ricky Seals-Jones, but, you know, it just never seems to work out for that guy. Philadelphia, who would I see fire? Boston Scott, I would cease fire on him. Philadelphia, they went out and they signed Kerryon Johnson, and it just feels like he's going to be active right before the game, and he's going to, you know, muddy everything up, you know. So I wouldn't trust that, you know, championship week. And Devonta Smith, guy's just too inconsistent, very talented, dynasty pickup for sure, but not something that you want for championship week. All right, so as I drop my pencil here. Okay, all right. So let's move on to the next one. All right, the next one is Carolina at 10-3. That can't be right. That has to be different. Yeah, whatever. I know those are not good. No. I'm not gonna say it. Yeah, this was not vetted correctly. So Carolina at New Orleans. Now that is vetted correctly. Okay, so noon, 47. Sorry about that, everybody. So it's gonna be 47. Well, it's gonna be a dome. Who cares what the degrees are? It's 38.5 point open over and under. The implied totals are Saints 22, Panthers 16. I'm gonna take the over on that. Carolina, can't trust anybody there, you know, seriously. So I would cease fire on everybody. Nobody shoot on. Sam Darnold will be starting with a little bit of Cam Newton mixed in, and that makes for all of the offensive weapons for Carolina very risky. And in championship week, I'd pivot to something else if that's possible. Okay, so that was real easy. Okay, sorry about DJ Moore. That's unfortunate. Hopefully they get the quarterback things figured out throughout this offseason. We'll see what the Lord says. New Orleans. Oh, man. Let's start with the good news. Defense. Yeah, I would go ahead and shoot on the defense. All right. And for the kicker, Brett Meyer, I can't argue for him, and I can't argue against him. Okay. So Jake Elliott, I would take over him. Badgley, I would take over him. You know, so take that for what you want. But let's get to the ugly. Alvin Kamara. Yeah, he's startable, but temper those expectations. I don't know how much was last week's awful performance due to the patchwork O-line, or how much is just how bad New Orleans is right now. It's championship week, and this is too scary to trust, all right? Ronald Jones Jr., Darrell Williams, Devin Singletary, all these guys are better options and better starts than Kamara. Okay, so yeah, so that is the end of who I would shoot on. Ceasefire, of course, Taysom Hill. He's just getting back from COVID, and Carolina allows the sixth fewest points to opposing quarterbacks. Okay, so that goes hand in hand with ceasefiring on all the passing options. So yeah, it's not going to be a good thing there. All right, so let's go ahead and move on to Denver at the Chargers. Now, this is a 3:05. Finally, we're getting to the 3 o'clock games. It's a, and this is, you know, a dome, so no worries about the weather. 46 point opening over and under. The implied totals are Chargers 26, Broncos 19. So I will take the under because I don't think that the Broncos are going to do that well. And also the Denver defense is, and we'll talk about it here in a second. So who we're going to shoot on? Let's go and shoot on for Denver. Let's do Javonte Williams and Melvin Gordon, but only look at him as low wide receiver two, okay, due to two things. You got the sharing time, so that's number one, obvious, all right? And then Drew Lock. I guess that's the second obvious thing. He lowers all the offensive weapons, all right? You have a ton of guys that are on COVID. You have Tim Patrick that's on COVID. I think Cortland Sutton. And, of course, Jerry Jeudy is on COVID. So, I mean, they're going to stack the box, man. You know, that's what they're going to do. They're going to run on us. You know, and so even though that the Chargers defense is pretty weak against the run, well, you know it's coming. You know, I mean, you can duck a punch if you know where it's coming at, right? Now, you could start Brian McManus since he's a good kicker. He's in a dome. But again, the offense doesn't seem like it's going to be able to move the ball that well. All right, so just keep that in mind. I wouldn't start the Denver defense, man. Herbert is at home, and they need to win to stay in playoff contention. He's better. The defense is better. The Denver defense is not bad. It's not a bad defense. I just don't know if they're going to be – if the defense is better than how bad than Drew Lock is. Drew Lock is stinks so bad that Denver defense has to be like uber, you know, in order to make up for it. I don't think they can. So for the Chargers, who would I go ahead and shoot on for the Chargers? Justin Herbert, you know, dude, he's got you there, you know, and he's capable of big weeks. So yeah, of course. Austin Eckler, but temper those expectations. You know, again, Denver defense is good. You know, they're not that bad. All right. They aren't that bad. And the Chargers before Eckler went on to the COVID list, the Chargers were managing his reps before, you know, so there is an argument that if you're in a pinch, Justin Jefferson is startable, you know, probably flex worthy, because he'll probably get more play than Austin Eckler managers will hope. So, yeah, I don't see a lot of work for Austin Eckler, to be honest with you. Keenan Allen. Okay. Now, I would shoot on Keenan Allen. Now he's able to hit higher numbers, but I'm expecting low wide receiver two numbers after how bad he was last week versus a weaker COVID affected Texans defense. Plus Mike Williams is back. So all those just show low wide receiver two. It's not going to win you, but it's not going to lose you. So, you know, do with it what you like. I'm sitting him for AJ Brown, by the way. In one of my league for the not for the championship, for the third place one. Okay, the ceasefire on the Chargers. Let's see, I would ceasefire on Mike Williams, Josh Palmer, Jalen Guyton. You know, it looks like it'll be Keenan Allen first, and then these guys splitting, but not a lot for any of them. Okay, so wouldn't go ahead and do that. Trey McKitty, that's a real dude. Okay, that's the backup tight end for the Chargers. Why? Because Jared Cook is on COVID list. All right, so he's going to be the only one out there. So a little bit of McKitty action out there, but I would not pick up or start Trey McKitty. He's just funny to say, Trey McKitty. Say it with me, 1, 2, 3, Trey McKitty, right? It's funny. Okay, the defense, I would ceasefire on the defense. Listen, they had a -3 output last week. That's another thing that hurt me last week. I had Tyreek Hill, I had Alvin Kamara, and I had the Chargers defense, and all that equaled into a big poo sandwich. So yeah, a -3 output last week is bad. Okay, first Houston, then that was against, you know, that was against Houston, so that's terrifying. All right, Dustin Hopkins, the little goose egg he gave you a couple weeks ago, terrifying. Yes, not something that you want to go ahead and have and help you sleep well tonight as you're waiting for your games to start, your championship week games to start next tomorrow. So yeah, just keep all that in mind. No, I would cease fire on them. Okay, let's go ahead and move on to Houston, 4-11, as San Francisco 8-7, It's a 305. It's going to be 51 degrees, 14% chance of rain, 5 to 10 mile an hour wind game. 44 point opening over and under. The implied Vegas point totals is 49ers 28. Texans 15, I go under. Under. No, that's an easy. That's Bet Your Kids College Fund. Easy. Under. Okay. Shoot. Who would I shoot on? Houston. Only person I would look at is Brandon Cooks. But look, listen to this. He's coming back from COVID. And Tyreek Hill, remember Tyreek Hill's stink bomb? Bellyaching about last week. That should warn you that deep threat receivers don't bounce back well from COVID. Okay. He's coming back from COVID. So no, you can go ahead and start him, but temper, low wide receiver two numbers right there. Okay. And that's it. That's the only one. Rex Burkhead. I know that he was awesome. But I would cease fire on him. That was against a sick and weak run defense. Okay. So don't trust it for championship week. Okay. And same thing with all the other weapons. Okay. So that was real easy shooter cease fire real quick for the Houston Texans. Let's do the same for San Francisco. Trey Lance. I would go ahead and shoot on him. All right. He isn't accurate at all. He is not accurate and doesn't make good decisions right now. He's just not NFL ready. But his legs will get him fantasy points a la Jalen Green. Okay. But it will lower the value of Deebo Samuel, Brandon Ayuk, and George Kittle. Okay, you can start these three, but temper expectations. I would prepare for floor games. Floor, L-F-L-O-O-R, floor. Floor games for these three, okay? So just telling you, man, okay? He's going to be running a lot. The defense, I would shoot on the defense and also shoot on Robbie Gould. Oh, my gosh, that's it? The end of the list? You're asking yourself, well, what about the darlings? What about the ones that all the fantasy football podcasts are saying, please start? Well, let's talk about them. Let's be real. Let's discuss it. Eli Mitchell. Okay, he's trending towards playing, but the quote from head coach Kyle Shanahan is, we'll play Elijah as much as he can handle. So that's about watching him, watching how his legs works, and communicating with him. That sounds like he isn't going to play the whole game, which that means you can't go to Jeff Wilson Jr. because you have Elijah Mitchell. You can't play Elijah Mitchell because they're going to be watching his snaps. And so, cease fire. Okay? All right? Seriously, don't fall for it. Cease fire. I hope I'm wrong. Okay? Seriously, I hope I'm wrong. I just don't see the pathway to how I could be regarding that. All right? Moving on, okay, to the Los Angeles Rams, 11-4, to Baltimore, 8-7. It's a 3:25 actually, game. 65 degrees in Baltimore, 40% chance of rain, 10 to 20 mile an hour winds, 46.5 point opening up over and under. The implied point totals are Rams 25, Ravens 21. Under. I'm taking the under. Yeah, that weather, that wind is going to be something else. All right. And see, here's the thing. Okay. 10 to 20 mile an hour winds, man. That means that they can fluctuate. If you get a ball in the air, starts off, it's 12 miles an hour wind, then you get a nice little poof up to 16. That thing's going to float. Right. So let's talk about it. The Rams. You shoot on Stafford, of course. You go ahead and shoot on Matthew Stafford. Not a bad idea. Same thing with Cooper Kupp. But temper expectations. Two things could happen here. All right. A problem. Okay. They're going to get some good points, but then it won't be consistent to the end of the game. All right. I would be surprised if the majority of your points from Matthew Stafford and Cooper Kupp come from the second half instead of the first half. I think it's going to be whatever at halftime. That's pretty much you're going to get, give or take five, maybe 10 points. Okay. Meh. Maybe you're right. 5 to 10 points PPR, right? Sony Michel. This is why, he is the lead back. And even though Baltimore is tough for this first of the run, it seems true to me. The Rams will get up quick and the second half will be all Michel. Akers was fun. It was exciting that he might play, but no, he's human. And so he's not going to play. Henderson's on IR. It's going to be a Sony Michel, man, against Baltimore. It's going to be really good. Yeah, he's a must start. Sony Michel is a must start. All right. So make sure and get him in your lineup wherever you can. Defense. I would go ahead and I would shoot on the defense. And then also Matt Gay. Yeah, Matt Gay, but the win is a factor, so make sure and temper those expectations. Baltimore, you're always starting Mark Andrews. You're always starting Justin Tucker. I know the weather's tough, but it's just hard not to trust either of these guys, right? Tyler Huntley. Let's talk about him. Now, the Lamar Jackson's trending towards not playing. Okay, so that means he's going to start, and he did well. Okay, but he's coming off of COVID. So, not much run. So, expect a low floor for him, or a low output for him, a floor game. For Tyler Huntley, okay? You know, it's going against the Rams, who's a tough defense. He's not going to be able to run. It just doesn't look good, you know? So he's actually a ceasefire, Tyler Huntley is. But if you want to start him, you can if you're in a pinch. But just expect low. So there's probably other things you can pivot on. Derek Carr. Yeah, I think I would do Derek Carr over Huntley. Ceasefire. Who are we going to ceasefire on with the Rams? Van Jefferson, yes. And OBJ. Okay, they're going to be splitting targets between behind Cup, you know, and so now the favorite would be OBJ because I think he's going to be the touchdown favorite. So he's flex worthy in deep leagues, but it's going to be Cup first. And if any defensive coordinator and all of the NFL ever figures it out, hopefully it'll be Baltimore because I'm playing against Cooper Kupp in the championship game, then Cooper Kupp's not going to have a good week. All right, just the way it's going to be. All right, it's going to be OBJ. All right, so it's going to be one of those things. Either OBJ's going to have a good week or Cooper Kupp. Somebody's going to do what? Something. I'm hoping that they shut down Cooper Kupp because it's, come on, man. It's sick you're that consecutive. It's sick. All right, if you have him, God bless you. Yeah, you can absolutely start that guy. Baltimore. I would cease fire on the running backs, and the running backs versus the Rams D is pretty bad. Okay, so it's just a bad idea. The wide receivers I would cease fire on. Marquise Brown is questionable with an illness, so even if he plays, he will be limited. Okay, and of course we already talked about Huntley with COVID, so that's that passing thing is gonna be weird. Holy mackerel, you hear that? Yeah, it's still My neighbors are still celebrating, man. Boy, that made me jump. That's gonna be funny to watch. Okay, let's move on to Detroit 2-12 to Seattle 5-10. Now that's a 3:25 start time. It's gonna be 42 degrees in Seattle, 90% chance of rain, 10-20 mile an hour winds, 42.5 open and under. Implied Vegas point total, Seahawks 24, Lions 18. Dang, that's a good number. Wow, that's a good number. Let's go over. Let's do that. Let's get crazy here. That's the game we're going to get crazy on, okay? And I'll tell you why. Detroit, I would shoot on DeAndre Swift and Amon-Ra St. Brown. Now, this is why I would go ahead and go over. I think that the Lions they have a very good chance of winning this game, especially how Seahawks did against Chicago. But listen to this. Seattle is weak versus the run, and they are weak against slot receivers, okay? Both those guys are incredible talents. So I think they're both going to have really good weeks this week. Start both of them. Be excited about starting both of them. That's why I'm putting Amon-Ra St. Brown over Justin Jefferson. I'm doing it. I'm putting my money where my mouth is. We'll see how I feel this time next week. you know. But again, like I said before, if it's the Lord's will, it doesn't matter what I do. I'll win if it's the Lord's will, one way or the other. But here we go. On Seattle. So the only people I would shoot on is DeAndre Swift, Amon-Ra St. Brown. Who do I see fire on? Everything else. I don't think I need to talk about anything else. That's rough. Okay, Seattle, Russell Wilson, I would go ahead and shoot on him based solely on how bad the Lions' defense is. Okay, he hasn't really done anything to make me trust him, but if you're in a pinch, you can go ahead and shoot on him. Rashad Penny, same reason. The Lions' D, that's the reason why you would want to do it. Okay, and then the next one, of course, would be Gerald Everett. Yeah, let's go ahead and talk about Gerald Everett. I'm pretty happy. I'm pretty happy with Gerald Everett. Okay, so this guy, I picked him up off the waiver wire because I had was it Freiermuth, right? And I was just not, I'm not trusting Freiermuth. I mean, we'll talk about it, but it's a Monday night game. Championship, come on, man. You know where I'm at. At the time, he wasn't practicing. So, but Gerald Everett has been Wilson's favorite target for the past couple of games, and it's the Lions defense. Okay, so he's been really surging. Everett has. Everett has been surging, and so has Amon-Ra St. Brown. These are ones that you want to jump on and put into your lineup championship week because these guys are surging, right? They're hitting right now, okay? Look at Tyler Lockett. Tyler Lockett, you can go and shoot on him. Okay, you can. You can get him in your starting lineup. But he was surging at the beginning. Then he's come back, hit a little bit, but he hasn't been on the up trajectory which Everett and Amon-Ra St. Brown are on. So yeah, just go keep that in mind. Now Seattle, DK Metcalf, unfortunately ceasefire on that guy. Okay, it's just not happening this year. It's championship week. If you have him, you're probably not in your championship. But I'm just saying, if you are, you do, and you do have him, ceasefire on him, or in DFS, ceasefire on him. I'm sure that's gonna be very. Actually, that's probably where the advice comes from is from the DFS, because if you think about it, his price is gonna be really low. So Seattle, ceasefire on DK Metcalf, ceasefire on the defense. DeAndre Swift is back, and Amon-Ra, like I said, he's surging. Again, Seattle is weak versus the run, and also against slot receivers. Ceasefire on that defense. Ceasefire on Jason Myers, the kicker. The weather is not conducive for kickers. So yeah, so ceasefire on both kickers. Okay, let's move on. We only have about three more games left, so just bear with me. I know we hit the 1 hour mark, but we're almost done here. So let's move on to the Arizona 10-5 at Dallas 11-4. So that's a 325 game. It's a dome game. No weather. Thank God. Thank you, Lord. You are merciful. 52 point over under. The implied totals are Cowboys 28, Cardinals still 23. I would go under on that. I don't think the Cardinals are going to score that much. Let's talk about it. Who would I shoot on for Arizona? Zach Ertz. He's the target monster on the team. Kyler Murray. Now, he hasn't been producing, and Dallas D is tough, but his legs and opportunities should get him at least low QB1 numbers, so that's what I would be expecting if I was to start him. Matt Prater, all right? But temper these expectations. I know they're in a dome, but Arizona will be more than likely playing from behind, and they love to go it for it on fourth down. All right? Frustrating. You can shoot on them, but just keep in mind that you're probably going to get low, either very low double digits or very high single digits. You know, so it's up to you. It's up to you on that. Dallas, of course, these are going to be real easy. Dak Prescott, yes. Zeke, yes. CeeDee Lamb, yes. Amari Cooper, yes. Defense, yes. Zerline, yes. That easy. Was it easy? Yes. Okay. Arizona, who you see fire on wide receivers. Now, on the wide receivers, yes. The wide receivers for Arizona sees fire. Dallas is tough versus them. Gets a very tough defense against the wide receivers. The running backs, now, there's a little bit of caveat here, okay? So right now it's a split time between Connor and Edmonds, but Connor hasn't been practicing. So if he's out, definitely shoot on Edmonds. Okay, just for volume alone. Dallas, who do I cease fire on? Dalton Schultz. Yes, Dalton Schultz. Arizona's tough versus tight ends. And the Arizona D is weak, okay, versus wide receivers. So that means that it's set up very well for Lamb and very well for Amari Cooper. So I have CeeDee Lamb, so Lord be merciful. Please allow that to be true. Okay, let's move on to Minnesota 7-8 and Green Bay 12-3. Okay, it's a seven. This is the night game. Check out the okay. This one is one that we're gonna need to talk about a little bit. Okay, so it's a 0 degrees, 5% chance of rain. 0 degrees, I said. Let me zero. Goose egg. Zero. 0 degrees. That's the prediction. 5% chance of rain, 6 mile an hour wind, 42.5 point over under. The implied point totals are Packers 27, Vikings 20. I would take the under on that when I even question. Okay, because I think that the Vikings are probably going to get a kick. Okay, that's wrong. That's bad. No. I think they're probably going to get around 14. I mean, I would say 17. So that's why I would go under. Ah, now that I'm talking it out, Packers 27. That's a good line against the Vikings. Yeah. I think it's going to be like right under, but barely. Right under, but barely. I don't think that Vikings are going to get 20, but I think they're going to get 2 touchdowns from Dalvin Cook. Yes, that's the only person that I would shoot on, Dalvin Cook. With Kirk Cousins out on COVID, the Vikings are starting Sean Mannion, who not only hasn't started a game in 2 years, but just got off the COVID list himself and will only get 1 practice as a starter. That is not a good concoction for a successful remedy for your playoff championship hopes. Wow, how you like that? I'm telling you, man, it's not good. It's not good. Jaire Alexander's back. All right, and so you have that guy back. You have you have this guy. Okay, playing in 0-degree weather, who's a dome team, okay, who's never played it before, and he's going to have to try to keep up. He's going to have the pressure of trying to keep up with Aaron Rodgers. No. So Justin Jefferson already, that's why he's benchable. That's why Amon-Ra St. Brown is more valuable than Justin Jefferson, as crazy as that sounds. Holy mackerel. KJ Osborne, Tyler Conklin, all these guys, sittable, all right? Benchable. Greg Joseph, same thing, all right? Now, it does. What this all points to, though, because you know me, I always like to look at the positives. Looks like it's going to be a huge opportunity for Dalvin Cook, since he has now recovered from COVID and has had a full week of practice. So I have Dalvin Cook in my championship week. Lord be merciful. Please allow this to be true. Oh, hope he has a great. He had a great game last time. Okay, he went over 100 yards, had a touchdown, you know, so, you know, I it's possible. It's there. Yeah, it can be there. So, Lord, please allow it to be your will. Green Bay, who would I go ahead and shoot on? Aaron Rodgers, Aaron Jones, A.J. Dillon, Davante Adams, and that's it. This seems like it's a game where Rodgers is going to get the Packers up early, and it'll be a lot of, like, Jones and Dillon in the first half. So, you know, I think that's the list there. The defense. I would definitely shoot on the defense. I just told you about the situation with the kicker or with the QB. So yeah, that's definitely a streamable defense if you're in a tough spot. Ceasefire, I already talked to you about with Minnesota, but on Green Bay, Mason Crosby. He's just hard to trust. He's just hard to trust on championship week. Okay, all right, everybody. We're making it. We got to the last game. This is the last game of the. Of the season, the last shooter sees fire of the season right here. This is it. The swan song until next year. So let's go to it. Cleveland 7-8, Pittsburgh 7-1. It's going to be 22 degrees. Okay. That's what it's saying it's going to be in Pittsburgh. 4% chance of rain, 6 mph wind, 41 point opening over and under. Implied Vegas total points are Browns 22, Steelers 18. I would take, let's get crazy. Let's go over. Let's do it. Yeah, let's go over. Who going to shoot on? Because I think the Steelers are going to do. I'll tell you why. I think the Steelers are going to score more on that and win this game. And that they. And I'll tell you why here in a second. So who would I shoot on? Cleveland. Nick Chubb, of course. Jarvis Landry, of course. Chase McLaughlin, exactly. The kicker, yeah, because, you know, it seems like it's going to be a good day. And so Pittsburgh. Who would I shoot on Pittsburgh? Najee Harris. You know, but of course, that's someone you always start. You never not start Najee Harris. Even against that terrible game against Kansas City last week in a PPR, he did 18 points. So, you know, he's still there. Deontay Johnson, Pat Freiermuth. If you're in a pinch, Big Ben is startable. Now, let me tell you why all this is and why I think Pittsburgh is going to win. All right, this is more than likely going to be Big Ben's last start in Pittsburgh. Okay, so I'm expecting all those emotions, it's going to put into an offensive explosion. Okay, this is where Johnson and Freiermuth are startable. Okay, Harris is always startable, but these guys, I think they're going to do really, really well. Okay, now again, Freiermuth, he's nerve wracking. You know, he's upgraded to full and everything like that. I'm still going with Gerald Everett over him, because again, this is all feel that I'm telling you. The stuff about Everett is fact. Okay, like about all of us, you can see where his production is going up. Freiermuth was kind of stating out, and also he had two concussions in the past month, and that's just scary. Okay, you know, like, because those things can come really fast, easily now. Deontay Johnson, again, if they're going to throw it deep, it's going to be to him. All right. So, and also I would shoot on Chris Boswell. Ceasefires are very easy, guys. They're very easy for Cleveland and for Pittsburgh. They're both the same thing. The defense. Yeah, I would not trust either one of those defense. I would definitely cease fire on any of those defense. And so with that, everybody, with that, that's the last shoot a ceasefire for this season. Hopefully it's going to be something that will help lead you to a championship or to a lot of money in DFS. Now, I want to make sure and thank everybody for watching. Thank you so much. I really appreciate that. And hit the like and subscribe button. And let's start out this new year off something good, man. You know, tell at least one person, help me grow the show. You know, I mean, if you're enjoying this, let everybody else know, man, so we can keep this thing going. I love doing it. Hopefully you love watching. So let's keep it going. Let's get it growing. All right. So also want to go ahead and thank the supporters, Sports Host app, High Volume Music Radio app, and also make sure and check out on every Thursday on highvolumemusicradio.com and the High Volume Music Radio app, Drive Time Sports with Charlie and Brian. Okay. From 4 to 6, make sure and check that out. So on behalf of me, your humble MC, Brian the Amigo Baldwin, I want to thank you for watching, and we hope that this year gets even better and better and better than the last. And well, hopefully, I'm hoping that this year, 2022, ends better than the way 2021 ended. Any ends with Betty White passing, that's terrible. So it's just got to get better, right? It's got to be a good year. My parting shot. Happy New Year, everyone. I hope the Lord provides everyone with a championship and in an incredibly blessed 2020. So, remember, everyone, and fantasy football, as in life, don't dream it, be it. Good luck, everybody. Seriously, I hope the Lord blesses you guys with the championship. Oh, Happy New Year.